Now, if you have seen, if you have studied the subject data structures and algorithms in your BTech, then you have, must have seen how a linked list look like. Okay, so I'm just going to draw a diagram to tell you what does a linked list look like. Okay, so a linked list looks something like this. Okay, so I'm going to take some dummy data for all the linked list so that you can easily see what are the concepts behind this linked list. Okay, so let us suppose this is the first node in the linked list and its base address is 1000, that is, it is stored in the address location 1000 in the memory, right? And it is storing some data and the data is A, right? And there's a pointer called head which is pointing to this linked list. This is the initial linked list and head is pointing to this linked list, therefore head is now going to store 1000. Now there are two or three different nodes in this same linked list. So let us suppose this is the node number 1, this was the node number 1, this is the node number 2, and it is storing the data B and its base address is 2000, that is, it is stored at the address location 2000 in the memory. Therefore this first node is storing 2000 here, that means this first node is pointing to this node. Okay, and then we are having this node number 3 which is storing the data C and its address is 3000, and this previous node is pointing to this node, therefore this previous node is going to store the data 3000, right? And there's one more node which is whose address is 4000 in the memory, so its address is 4000 and this previous node is pointing to this node, therefore it is storing 4000. Okay, so that is why it is pointing to this node and it is storing some data which is D. Okay, and it is storing null here because this is the last node. In some cases you may find that in the null node they have denoted some representation like this, that it is earth, right? This earth representation is going to denote that this is a node which is storing null in the address part. Okay, now this is how a linked list look like. Okay, so all these basic units in this linked list, so all these basic units are called the node. And in all these basic units we are having the similar structure, that means for example the first node we are having a structure like which is a data part and the link part, and then here also there's a data part and there's a link part, and here also there's a data part and there's a link part, and here also there's a data part and there's a link part. And all these nodes are of the same type, right? All these nodes are having the same structure. So if I define the node for the structure for all these nodes, how does it look like? So it does look like something like this: struct node. Okay, and then it is having this data part which is storing some character. So I'm going to do character data, and then this link part is going to store the address of the next node. So I'm going to do struct node star link. That means this link is of type structure. Okay, so that means this link is going to store the address of the one more variable which is of type node. Okay, and this is how a structure look like. So whenever we have to initialize a variable of this type of structure, we have to write struct node q. That means this q variable is of type node. Now remember, whenever we try to initialize a variable of type of any structure type, then we have to write struct keyword in before this, right? So if you do not want to write the struct keyword, then we use the keyword which is known as type def, and the full form is type definition, right? So whenever I write after this structure, I have to write type def struct node. Okay, that means wherever I have to write node, I'm just going to write node, right? So to declare a variable, then I have to do node q. I don't have to write struct node every time again. I just have to write node q. That means this q variable is of type node, and this node is actually a type definition for this struct node thing. Okay, so this is how you can just use node to write a structure, to initialize a variable of type this node. Okay, but in the case of linked list, we are not going to initialize a variable like this. We are going to use we are going to allocate some memory to a linked list by using the malloc function, and then we are going to return the address of that node, and then we are going to store the address of that node into a pointer of type node. Okay, then means let us see how to explain this. Let us see how to create a node in the linked list. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write a function which is going to create a node into this linked list. Okay, so let us write a create node function which is going to create a node, and then it is going to return the address of that newly created node, right? So what I'm going to do is create node. Okay, and it is going to take some data. The data can be of type character and the data can be of type integer. So here, because we are taking this character data into the structure, therefore this data should be of character type, right? So it should be character data or character information here. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to do node star p. Okay, that means this p is a pointer of type node. Okay, and then I'm doing p is equal to node star malloc. Okay, and then here in the size of function I just have to write size of node. Okay, and then so what is this malloc function is going to do? This malloc function is going to allocate the specified amount of memory. So here the specified amount of memory is given by the size of function. So this is size of function is going to give what is the size of a node. So then after that we get the size of the node, and this size of the node will be in terms of integer number, and this malloc function is going to allocate that much amount of memory which is returned with, by this size of function. Okay, and then it is going to return the address of that memory. So if you want to store that address into a variable of type node, that means we have to type cast that address. Therefore here this node star, here I'm going to do type casting for that address, and then we are going to do p of data. That means in the previous session I've told you how why we use this array notation. So whenever we have a variable which is of type the defined structure, then we use dot definition. But whenever we have a pointer which is pointing to a structure, right, then to access the memory locations which is inside this structure, we use this arrow notation. So when I'm doing p arrow data is equal to small a, okay, or then I'm doing p arrow link is equal to null. Okay, and then I'm doing return p. So this is the structure of a node. So here when I'm returning p, this p is of type node, it is a pointer of type node, therefore I have to specify a return type here. So a return type will be node star. Okay, so what does it mean? Here in this program I have taken some information from the user as the input parameter for this function. That means it is going to take some character from the user, and then it is going to initialize a pointer which is of type node. So this pointer is of type node, and then it is going to allocate that much amount of memory which is the size of this node, and then it is going to return the address of that memory. So this address is now stored in this p. So that means there's some memory is allocated in our system. So this memory is having two parts. So one is the data part and another one is the link part, and it is having some address. So maybe the address is 5000. So this memory is having sub address, and this address is stored by this pointer p. So p is storing 5000. Now in the data part, here in this line I'm saying p arrow data is equal to a. That means in the data part I am storing a small a, and then here in this line I am saying p arrow link is equal to null. That means in the null link part I am going to store null. Okay, and then I am returning p. That means p is a pointer which is storing the base address of this linked list. Therefore we are going to return this address of this newly created node. So this is base address of this node actually, not the linked list, because it is still a node. So we are going to return the address of this newly created node to the calling function. That means from where we have called this create node function. Okay, so this is a basic function which is used to create a node into the linked list. Okay, so whenever we need to create a node, we just call this function, and this function is now going to create a node. Okay, now let us write a program. Now let us see what are the different operations into the linked list. Okay.